Hey everyone, and welcome to Premiere Basics, a weekly series where we teach you all the ins and outs of Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, who doesn't like a good music video? I love it when a music video has an amazing cinematography and feels like a movie. And I sure love it when they use some amazing effects that make my mind go boom. So, for today, I decided to create three effects for you guys that are super simple to make in Premiere Pro. Now, you can use these for music videos, but you can also use these for other projects as well. Now, the first effect is chromatic aberration. Now, normally, when we are shooting something with a camera, we don't want chromatic aberration. It's a kind of color fringing and dispersion that you see around the focal point of your shot when your lens isn't that great. The lens can basically not focus all of the colors at the same point. But enough theory for now, let's skip to the practical function of it. When you're adding it in post, it creates a cool effect, which gives a little bit of a cheap 3D look in my opinion, but it also creates a kind of focus on your subject. Okay, now let's jump straight into Premiere Pro, and we're gonna start by placing our clip in the timeline, of course. Next, we're going to apply the lens distortion effect. Now play around with the curvature to get your desired look. What I like to do is animate the curvature over time so that there is a bit of a lens distortion motion in the shot. And then I'm going to apply the VR chromatic aberrations effect. Now disable the auto VR properties and choose stereoscopic over under as a frame layout. Then offset the red, blue and green aberration channels. And once again, I'm going to animate these to give a more dynamic look. Now I'm gonna leave the falloff distance to 50, and lastly, I'm going to make a circular mask within the effect, invert it and feather this a bunch so that my subject still remains perfectly in focus without any aberration. And that's it for the chromatic aberration effect. Now, this looks quite nice, but if you have the money, I recommend buying the Red Giant Universe pack, since their chromatic aberration effect is way more cooler and has more controls. And it also comes with a lot of other effects. Now the next effect is rewinding or fast forwarding, whichever one you prefer. Now I think this is a great way to reuse a specific setting in your edit or whenever you want to transition to another setting. Now I'm gonna start off by duplicating my clip to track number 2. And you can do this by holding Alt while dragging. Next I'm going to place a cut on clip number 1 where I want the clip to stop and rewind. And I do this with the eraser tool or C on your keyboard. Then I'm going to delete everything behind the cut. On the exact same frame, I'm going to freeze frame track number 2 by adding a frame hold. It will automatically create a cut, so I'm going to delete the first part of it. Then I'm going to duplicate the clip on track number 1 and place it behind the freeze frame and reverse it. And you can do this by right-clicking on the clip, selecting speed duration, and then check the reverse speed checkbox. If we now play this, it will play the video, then pause the video, and then reverse the video. It's cool, but we're not there yet. With the rate stretch tool or R on your keyboard, I'm going to fasten the reversed clip. Next, I'm going to place a keyframe on the scale of the freeze track, and I do this in the beginning. Then I'm going to go a few frames further and scale it up just a tiny bit. On the end of the clip, I'm going to do the opposite, making it go back to its original scale. Then I'll use the Lumetri color effect and animate the saturation on the exact same keyframes as the scaling, making it go from 100% to 0% in a few frames, and at the end, we do the opposite. Now basically our effect is done, but we can spice it up even more by placing some distortion effects on here. Like for instance the chromatic aberration effect that we've made before. Or we can animate a text or play button with the effect controls to add extra flavor to it. And of course, don't forget to add some sound effects. Now the last effect is actually a really customizable one. Picture in picture. Now, what is this? Well, it's basically using multiple clips on screen at the same time. However, you can do this the boring way by just placing a clip on top of another clip or duplicating the clip on track number 1, then selecting the top clip, go to the effect controls and scale it down. Or you can do this the awesome way and play around with a bunch of effects, transitions and presets on these pips, as I call them. For example, what I did here is duplicate the bottom clip a bunch of times, placing them on different tracks, and then I trim the clips so that each of them starts a bit later than the other one. Then I rescale every clip by 10% less than the clip underneath, So my bass clip has a scale of 100, the clip on top has a 90% scale, then 80% and so on. Then I play some different clips on there, which I rescaled again and cropped using the crop effects, which you can find in the effects library. And with the crop properties, you can crop this clip so it appears to be vertical. Now the last clip has a camera overlay on top. I then nested these together by right clicking on them and choosing nest. And then from the effects library, I use the transform effect to adjust the position from off screen to on screen so it flies in. Now you can spice up things even more by adding some texts on here, which we can do with the text tool or T on your keyboard. Place, scale and rotate them wherever you want using the effect controls. And lastly, we use some flares or other overlays, which we can find on story blocks. And these add some extra elements to the video. Now cut everything to the beat of the music. And of course, you can play around with these effects and a bunch of other clips. Now let's put all of these effects together, get creative with them, and create a super dope music video. I'm all for the mission to pray for the tension, because the best of us come with complacency issues. And in the chosen and high, cause we're placing on picking the tissues. They're thinking and crying and laughing and aim for the miss you. I've been up like all night, working on the crab cause the sucker don't ball right. Doing about to swing cause we ain't about to fall. I'm living on my knees cause I know it ain't all I own. Bam! A super dope music video that will blow everyone's mind. You know what else blew my mind? Well, all those amazing classes on Skillshare. Now, I've seen quite a lot of them, so you could say that I'm multi-talented. Anyway, if you want to become a multi-talented filmmaker yourself, then have a look at our Skillshare classes. Like for instance, the After Effects class, where you learn all of the basics of Adobe After Effects. Which will be a big help, by the way, if you want to create more fire edits for music videos. Now, with the link below, you will get 2 months of free access to Skillshare, so stop the video. Like, do it now. I mean, seriously, do it now. Just pause the video and go to the link below and start your class. 'Cause I'll see you next week, and as always, stay creative.